It's one of the fluffy covers that goes over the mic. And I tested it out before I started making this video, and I think it makes some pretty good sounds. And the best part is, for me, is that it's pink. And I love pink. That is my favorite color. And I do have a pink mic, too. I'll try to show it to you here. How cute is that?
Isaac pleaded with the Lord on behalf
sons in your womb will become two nations from the very beginning. The two nations will be rivals. One nation will be stronger than the other, and your older son will serve your younger son. Wife Rebecca, he said, "This is my sister." He was afraid his window and saw Isaac, Chris, and Rebecca. So this is just like when Abraham told everybody in like Egypt and other places that they went to that Sarah was his sister, except for he was telling the truth. Fresh water. But then the shepherds from Gerar came this is our water, they said. And they argued over it with Isaac's herdsman. So Isaac named the well Esek, which means argument. Isaac's men then dug another well, but again there was a dispute over it. So Isaac named it Sitna, which means hostility. Abandoning that one, Isaac moved on and dug another well. This time there was no dispute over it. So Isaac named the place Rehoboth, which means open space. For he said, at last the Lord has created enough space for us to prosper in this land. From there, Isaac moved to Beersheba, where the Lord appeared to him on the night of his arrival. I am the God of your father Abraham, he said. Do not be afraid, for I am with you, and I will bless you. I will multiply your descendants, and they will become a great nation. I will do this because of my promise to Abraham, my servant. Then Isaac built an altar there and worshipped the Lord. He set up his camp at that place, and his servants dug another well. One day, King Abimelech came from Gerar with his advisor Ahuzath and also Phicol, his army commander. Why have you come here? Isaac asked. You obviously hate me since you kicked me off your land. They replied, we can plainly see that the Lord is with you, so we want to enter into a sworn treaty with you. Let's make a covenant. Swear that you will not harm us, just as we have never troubled you. We have always treated you well, and we sent you away from us in peace. And now look how the Lord has blessed you. See, I told you God was with Isaac all along. Just like he is with us these days. So, you know, if we're banished from our friend group, or if we get fired from our job wrongfully, or, you know, we just get sent away from our whole country wrongfully, just know that God has bigger, better plans for us, and that he is always with us. It may not feel like it, but he sure is. He will never leave us. He will never forsake us or abandon us. So Isaac prepared a covenant feast to celebrate the treaty, and they ate and drank together. Sorry. Early the next morning, they each took a solemn oath not to interfere with each other. Then Isaac sent them home again, and they left him in peace. That very day, Isaac's servants came and told him about a new well they had dug. We've found water, they exclaimed. So Isaac named the well Sheba, which means oath. And to this day, the town that grew up there is called Beersheba, which means well of the oath. At the age of 40, Esau married two Hittite wives, Judith, the daughter of Beeri, and Basemath, the daughter of Elon. But Esau's wives made life miserable for Isaac and Rebekah. And the reason being, I think, is because they were Hittites, and One day, when Isaac was old and turning blind, he called for Esau, his older son, and said, "My son." "Yes, father," Esau replied. "I am an old man now," Isaac said, "and I don't know when I may die. Take your bow and a quiver full of arrows and go out into the open country to hunt some wild game for me. Prepare my favorite dish and bring it here for me to eat. Then I will pronounce the blessing that belongs to you, my firstborn son, before I die." But Rebecca overheard what Isaac had said. Master over your brothers, and may your mother's sons bow down to you. has cheated me twice. First, he took my rights as the firstborn, and now he has stolen my blessing. Oh, haven't you saved even one blessing for me? And this is how we know where Jacob's name comes from and why it means deceiver, is because he has deceived his own father. And he even tricked Esau into selling his birthright to him. Isaac said to Esau, I have made Jacob your master, and have declared that all his brothers will be his servants. I have guaranteed him an abundance of grain and wine. What is left for me to give you, my son? Esau pleaded, but do you have only one blessing? Oh, my father blessed me too. Then Esau broke down and wept. Finally, his father Isaac said to him, you will live away from the richness of the earth and away from the dew of the heaven above. You will live by your sword and you will serve your brother. But when you decide to break free, you will shake his yoke from your neck. So that was more of kind of like a curse than a blessing. So from that time on, Esau hated Jacob because their father had given Jacob the blessing. And Esau began to scheme, I will soon be mourning my father's death. Then I will kill my brother Jacob. But Rebecca heard about Esau's plans. So she sent for Jacob and told him, listen, Esau is consoling himself by plotting to kill you. So listen carefully, my son. Get ready and flee to my brother Laban in Haran. Stay there with him until your brother cools off. When he calms down and forgets what you have done to him, I will send for you to come back. Why should I lose both of you in one day? Then Rebecca said to Isaac, I'm sick and tired of these local Hittite women. I would rather die than see Jacob marry one of them. So that was kind of like an excuse for Jacob to be on his way to Laban in Haran. That was the excuse that she gave to Isaac. So that no one would notice what she had heard Esau say and become suspicious. So that is all the reading that I will be doing for the day. Basically, it was just a lot of deception going on in these chapters here, in these three chapters, I would say. But God always makes a way, even through our sins. And, you know, I'm not saying that we should sin or anything like that. We're supposed to stay away from it. But, you know, God always takes care of his chosen ones. He always will. So, that's about all that I have for today. And I really hope that this video has been a blessing to you and that it relaxed you. I tried to brush the mic with my hands. I just love the way that it feels, but I try to do that throughout the whole video, and hopefully it sounds good enough to be relaxing and to be able to get something out of the word today. You know, I don't really use ASMR videos myself to help me to go to sleep. I use it to help keep me calm while I'm doing chores around the house. Or sometimes I listen to them whenever I'm on my lunch break at work, and just to try to help refocus and relax and stuff. You know, it's really good to get a blessing from the word and just to relax and help stay calm. So.